Ang liwanag ng ilaw ko. Magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Ako po si Trixie Cruz Angeles. Ito ang Luminous. Wow, ang dami kaagad na nasa sa Facebook at saka sa YouTube. So hi kay Ma'am Tessie, Win Mallory, CRTB, Pobreng Pinoy, William, Captain, Pialo, Roselle, Glenn, Edna, Kit, Alan D., Benedict, Ryan, Tony, Jelly, Leticia, Jeff, Roy, Edmond, Dexy, Juanito, Vivian, Barkadahan Forever, Mon, Owen, Gloria, Dolores, HJ, Dipatatas, Guy, Giggs, Castillo, Cabal, ELC, Rene, Elena, Sunny, uy, dami na sa Facebook, Anchi, hi, good evening din sa mga nanonood sa atin sa TikTok, BP Pest Control Services, Jesus Ice Cream, Rowena Holion, Erlinda Salinas, Lisa Ten, who's asking for a shout-out in Taiwan, hi kay Ma'am Lisa, XOXO, Jean, tama ba? Pogzu, Robbie, Just Ann, Papagong, Ray, John, sorry, Pogzu, NSM, etc. Okay, ang dami niyo na pala. Alright, so magandang gabi. We're talking about, of course, that video, yung pinag-uusapan ng matagal na ni Madam Maharlika. At today, nag-comment po si FPRD. And he was asked about the video. So I hope maririnig po ninyo ito. I have, nasa TikTok din, I took a portion, I excerpted a portion of the video and nasa TikTok natin. But let's play this one. Hopefully maririnig. Okay. There you go. Yes, he says, video. Wala yan. Yung video.
I can say that every
So he says, wala yan. Well, I can say dito maraming mayor, dito maraming leader nagtitake ng you know what. Tapos, he says further,
there's no such thing. Kasi kung andyan
there's no such thing. Sabi niya, there's no such thing. Kasi kung andyan pa yan, matagal nang lumabas yan. Okay. And that's it.
Wala yan.
Wala yan. Inulit pa niya.
Mayor, ayo.
Okay, so, ngayon, maraming, oops, maraming nagtatanong ngayon kung anong ibig sabihin nun or what is our take on that. Alright, so this is what he says. So he says first, wala yan. Okay. Kasi merong video na pinag-uusapan and he says, wala yan. And then he says something, here's something I can say. And he talks about maraming leader dito, may mga mayor na nagtitake ng illegal na substances. Or one particular one, no? Tapos he goes on to say, wala yan kasi kung totoo yan, matagal nang lumabas yan. So what can we pick up from this? Well, first, nalihis siya and it seems that alam niya yung puntirya ng video but he says, what he says is there's several leaders at may mga mayor daw na nagtitake ng ganon. Implying that this is entirely possible, that the event allegedly contained in the video, whatever it is true because there are others who do that. And then he says, wala yan, kasi kung totoo yan, matagal nang lumabas yan. What is he establishing? Hindi sa inaano niya, no? Hindi sa binabaliwala niya. Kasi he doesn't say whether or not he believes in it. So, except nang sinasabi niya is merong ganon in, there are certain leaders who actually do something like that. Pero ang sinabi niya is, kung totoo yan, lumabas na yan. Ang tingin ko, this is my opinion ha, ang tingin ko dyan is he's establishing a fact, several facts. Number one, that he's not involved in it, in the video, and two, he does not know for sure that it exists. Okay, so what is he establishing? No, wala siyang kinalaman dito. He's not saying it directly, but he's saying wala siyang kinalaman dito. The reason ito yung interpretation ko is kasi a week ago, may nag message sa akin from the military, from that group that supposedly or allegedly saw this alleged video. Hindi niya sinasabing siya, no, but he is saying that merong kasing umikot na balita na maraming may hawak ng alleged copies ng alleged video na yan, and that they had seen it. And ang sabi is a group of PMAers daw ay meron na nun. So may umikot na balita na merong mga may hawak na kopya na ganun. And according to the rumor mill, isa doon si dating Pangulo. So in saying this, what he's saying is hindi niya, wala siyang kinalaman dyan, hindi niya alam yan, and he doesn't believe it exists. Kasi yung existence niyan is simply a matter of belief right now. And sa kanya, hindi siya naniniwala. Of course, lahat yan mapabubulaanan pag lumabas, kung mayroon man ang video na yan. So, mahalaga yan, lalo na sa panahon ngayon. Kasi may mga ino-oppress, di ba? May mga pinatatahimik, may mga tinitreten, nakakasuhan. Kasi kahit ako mismo, may nag-message na sa amin na, hala, makukulong ka or something like that. You're in trouble. Pagka yan, may nangyari, you're going to be in trouble. Ginaganon ako. So, mayroong calls na nagaganon at meron din minsan nasa message. Okay. So, and therefore, ang tingin ko is, yun yung, that's one way of dealing with that issue. May mga iba, ang interpretation nila ay china-challenge nilang ilabas yung mga kopya na yan. But I don't think so. Kasi may timing ang lahat. So, may timing ang lahat ng ito. Bakit ko sinasabing may timing? Bakit sinasabi na hindi pwedeng ilabas yan ngayon? Okay. Ang tingin ko dyan is, the reason naghihinala ang administrasyon dito kay VP Inday at kay former President Duterte, hinala, take note, is because of the GMA formula. Okay? Noon, nung si GMA ay Vice President, there are two versions of this, no? Nagkaroon ng coup, supposedly. Well, quote-unquote. Or a rebellion, and they were able to take over. Ang ruling ng Supreme Court doon is, on whether or not maaaring tumakbo pa si GMA, ang sabi ng Korte Suprema, dahil umabot ng 2 years, yes, entitled si GMA to another term of 6 years. Something, nung umabot ng 3 years, sorry, 2 or 3 years, 2 years, I think, ay umabot, 2.5, ay, because of that, maaari pa siyang tumakbo ng isang term. So, ito kasi yung reason kung bakit very insecure at very worried ang administrasyon dun sa mga Duterte. We know that VP Inday had no plans of anything. We know that President Duterte has repeatedly said he is retired, he's no longer seeking office. Although once in a while, sinasabi niya, takbo kaya ako. If in-impeach si Inday, I will have no choice but to return to politics. So, yun yung konteksto. Kaya worried na worried yung administrasyon, baka sila maerap. Diba? At kung maerap sila, hindi yan gagawin nang maaga pa lang within the first year. Kasi dahil yung Supreme Court ruling, parang 2 years or more pa kailangan para ma-entitle yung VP to run for another term. And therefore, it is important for former President Duterte to indicate and send a strong signal na wala siyang interest, na he's not interested in any kind of takeover, na wala siyang interest dun sa ano, sa pagpapalit ng leadership, and that he himself is retired. He did not even talk to any of the military, di ba? Wala siyang kausap na PNP kasi sabi niya, sinong siraulong military o police ang maniniwala sa akin? Bakit pupunta sila sa akin? So he also denied that in the same interview. Ngayon, like I said, nobody yet really knows except for the people who actually hold it, who if that video exists. Okay? Ngayon, ito yung ano, ito yung, this is what I think worries people. Is indicative of something. Kasi tignan niyo, bakit worried ang administrasyon? Bakit sila worried to the point that they don't address the issue? Dinededman nila. And at the point where a lot of people, it's starting to snowball, kailangan i-address nila yung issue na ito because it might have a destabilizing effect. Diba? Now, the rule always is for any government to protect itself. The state protects itself. Okay? So yung mga nagsasabing, bakit hindi nilalabas yung video? Because if there is an intent, I'm not saying there's any. What I'm saying is, if there is an intent or they want to make sure that there is a way out, kasi pag lumabas yung video na yan, there will be hell to pay, so to speak. Maraming, we know that this administration, particularly acting through the Congress, can have a tendency to be oppressive. So, kung lumabas ang video na yan, kailangan may counter threat. And the counter threat is that should there be an uprising, a legal one or whatever, then there is a possibility of a 9-year presidency for the one who takes over. Okay? So naintindihan nyo kung bakit timing yan. That's why no matter what you say, no matter what the pressure, yung sabi ng sabi, ilabas nyo yan, hindi yan ilalabas if it exists. Okay? On a strategic viewpoint, if it does exist, hindi yan talaga lalabas ngayon. Kasi masyadong maaga. Look, hypothetically, let's say there is a president, Philippine president, and unstable siya. If early in his term, let's say within 1 year, he has to cede his position and it goes to the vice president. The vice president will only serve for the term vacated by the president. Gets nyo? Pero kung after 2 years ay nag-take over yung vice president, because the president is incapacitated, that vice president can run for another 6 years, giving her a 9-year term based on the GMA formula. Okay? I have no opinion on this. You'll have to stop asking me opinions for now, okay? Okay. So, I hope everybody gets it. So it is a matter of timing. So the challenge na if it exists, then dapat lumabas na yan. But for those, my dog came back from the hospital. Okay. So if it does exist and the people want to make sure that they have a fallback position, oo na ano, he may sugat siya, he had surgery, so he just came back. So if whoever it is, if the vice president or whatever interest group, no, not the vice president, wala siya talaga interest, and I can say that based on my personal knowledge. Now, if there is a group that wants to take over, okay, then they cannot allow the takeover to be by right of succession right now. Kasi based on the GMA formula, sino man ang mag-takeover when the president has served less than 2 years or 3 years, then that successor can only serve for the remainder of the term, which means 3 years. Okay? But if it is 3 years, then they, kumbaga, 3 years or more, then that person who succeeds can still run for another term. So yun po ang hindi na nakikita ng mga nagcha-challenge. Yung mga nagsasabi na, ano, oy, kung totoo yan, ba't di nilalabas? Kasi masama pa ang timing. Okay? So, why did I use this one? Bakit ito ang tingin natin na, ano, na possibility? Because ever since, from the start, alam natin na ang kapraningan ng administrasyon kay VP Inday is makasila mairap. Okay? Now, bakit sila praning na baka sila mairap? Because they are aware that for so many months already, or for over a year or so, sino tong si, ano, why are you so clean? Ano sinasabi mo? Sino kausap nyo? Wala naman akong sinabing clean. Pinagsasabi nito. Okay, next. So, kung right of succession, diba, kung may magsasucceed sa presidency, the amount of time that that successor will serve will depend on how long this president serves. So yung kapraningan nga will, ano, kasi kung less than, kung remainder lang ng term ng presidente, then 2028, yung elections will still be hit or miss. We don't know who will win. Diba? Okay. Sabi ni PBK, kaya pala may nagsasabing six, ano, something might happen and so. So magmo-monitor din pala ako ng ano. Magmo-monitor din ako kasi yung dito sa ano, sa Luminous Group, hindi lumilitaw yung name eh. So I have to check the name. The ano, the names. Ayan. Give me a second, guys. There you go. Guys, talaga natawag ko sa inyo. All right, there. Okay. So, we know na which ones will ano. So yung mga ganyan na comments, for example, why are you so clean? You're going to have to relate it. What is your antecedent fact? Okay. So, but take note that this is a theory. Of course, we don't know this for a fact. We don't know if this is, but this is a what we call a logical scenario given why the, ano, kasi, Kung a person holds this and knows that he or she has a capacity to wreak havoc or to create a wide impression of incompetence due to corruption of the current administration, then, di ba, nasa interest nga nilang ilabas yan. And they know that if you say that a video exists but you don't bring it out, people will say it's not likely to exist. So, nagkakaroon sila ngayon ng pressure to bring it out. Pero very confident sila that the video exists and very confident sila of the timing of bringing it out. Hindi sila nape-pressure to bring it out. And on this one, then we will have to bring in another factor. And that factor is the possibility of a GMA formula. Yun, no? Sabi ni, ano, ni Rafael Bautista, ERAP had the Jose Velarde envelope, BBM, the Pulvoron video. Now, kung ito yung magiging context, okay, I will bring your attention once more to ERAP. Now, ERAP was undergoing an impeachment trial. Does this sound familiar to you? Diba? What happened a few months ago? May nadulas, may nagkwento sa media na pinag-uusapan na may impeachment. Okay? Who was supposed to be impeached a few ago? Because if that person is not removed, then she has the right of succession in case something happens. Diba? In case that the current president is challenged. Okay. So, yun. Yung ang nakakatawa dito is because I'm also monitoring the negative comments. No, you're not, okay. So, we're monitoring the negative comments and merong mga nagpipilit na ilabas yan if it exists. But again, what I'm saying here is that there is a plausible reason why it is not coming out. There is a plausible reason why this one is very carefully kept also. Okay? Now, why don't they want an immediate succession? Kasi it means that the term of the successor will only be for the balance of the term of this president. So hanggang 2028 lang. So kung hanggang 2028 lang, mayroon pang mga malalakas dyan who can challenge this presidency in the next presidency. Kumbaga, what if and this is just a what if. This is purely hypothetical. What if the speaker runs for president in 2028? Yeah. If you're going to keep yourself safe, you want to make sure that in 2028, whoever the candidates are, you have the strong candidate. So, natatawa ako dun sa mga mga toxic comments kasi they're losing logic eh. Okay? Nakakatawa eh. Nakakatawa na yung because I don't think they saw this coming. They didn't see this explanation. So may panabla talaga. People who keep saying walang video kasi kung sakasakaling walang video, kung sakasakaling meron, dapat lumabas na yan. And even President Duterte is saying that. Why? Because the timing is still bad. Okay? At least siya may reason siya for saying that. Wala yan. So kailangan humupa yung speculation about the video. But wala naman kasing mawawala if later when the time is right, then lumabas yan. Again, I'd like to emphasize, this is a theory. I'm not saying this is what's going to happen, but this is the plausible reason kung bakit hindi yan nilalabas. Of course, pwede rin namang walang video kaya hindi yan lumalabas, di ba? So, but on the other hand, why are they so scared? Ito yung issue dyan eh. If the video doesn't exist, then these people don't have anything to worry about. The ones who have everything to lose have nothing to worry about. Walang video eh. Diba? There's no video. So, it doesn't, of course, hindi siya natatabla completely, but at least pwede mong sabihin, naman, you have to present the thing. May rule kasi sa evidence na there's no, what we call the best evidence rule. So, there's no best evidence other than the video. You can talk about the video, you can say that it exists, you can have pictures of the video, sino ba yan? Si Ignacio Bunye, di ba? I have two discs, the left and the right. Remember this? Ignacio Bunye was the press secretary or spokesperson of President GMA when she was accused of stealing the elections. And she was recorded. So nung lumalabas na yung yung lumabas yung audio na yan, what happened? Secretary Bunye had to address the issue, so he had to have his left and right audio recordings. Di ba? Natatawa na ako dun sa mga comments. Hindi, natatawa ako because of the comments. Walang nag-expect, so they don't know how to answer that possibility. But you know, these things exist. At alam naman natin to. All I'm giving is a plausible theory as to why that video isn't coming out. Now, also, the other reason why so many people believe that there is a video and that it exists is because the administration refuses to acknowledge it. Na at some point, pag widespread na yung belief na yan, your failure to acknowledge it has a destabilizing effect. Okay? Yes, theory din na yung video. Ano ba kayo? Meron ba nakakita ng video? Wala naman sinasabi dito na it definitely exists, di ba? But there is evidence to indicate that regardless of whether it exists or not, the administration, which should be reacting by now, is not doing so. And instead, undertaking activities that indicate that there is something wrong. O bakit na ano nawawala yung mga ibang bloggers? Bakit na te-take down? At hindi na coincidental. Maharlika, Banat Bai, Sas, and then Joey. What's the rule? One is an act of God. Two is a coincidence. Three is human intervention. And yes, that's science-based. Eto si Juan daw, sinasabi, wala naman pala. Ma'am, hindi ko sinasabing wala. Ang sinasabi ko is nobody knows if it exists or not. However, there is evidence that the evidence is starting to weigh in favor of its existence. Ano ang kinatatakutan ng mga nasa gobyerno kung hindi totoo, kung walang video? Okay? So, natatawa na ako dun sa ano. I'm sorry, I apologize if it seems insulting. But, so yun. Sabi ni Agustin, sobrang planning nila nagte-take down na sila ng FB, di kaya magtataka ka din. Oo. So sabi ni Gerald, scenario po, what if HOR impeaches Sara, who will be next in line? Wait, the HOR, well, can only conduct an impeachment, but the impeachment trial still has to be done by the ano? So the impeachment still needs, oh my goodness, I'm so sorry. The impeachment still has to be done by the impeachment trial still needs to be done by the Senate. Pero tama yung pagkagamit mo ha, na it's the House that impeaches because impeachment means you go to trial. Now, but what you're saying is that if the HOR impeaches, meaning matanggal si VP, then said video is released, did the succession, no, ganito yan, di ba? We talked about a vacancy in the office of the vice president. Kapag may presidente pero nawala for whatever reason yung vice president, to fill up that position, hindi po Senate president at walang succession for vice president. Ibig sabihin, the president will choose from the House or the Senate and they will affirm voting separately or jointly whoever is going to be put in there. So, remember GMA? She was vice president, she became the president. She chose Chofisto Gingona to be her vice president. And at the time, he was in Congress, in the House. So, kinuha niya yung ato. That's how it's done. So if the vice president, the office of the vice president is vacant, the president chooses the replacement. So para dun sa mga hindi naniniwala, I think it's Article 9 sa Constitution. Check nyo lang. Sabi ni Glenn, kailan kaya ang right time to expose the video? Wait, you're assuming there's a video. So, assuming, dapat ganon, assuming there is a video, when is the right time to expose it? It will depend, di ba? It will also depend on whether or not it is actually incendiary. Remember yung envelope nung kay ERAP? yung Jose Velarde ERAP envelope, yung impeachment ni ERAP, hindi naman ganun kalala yung nasa loob ng envelope, but the senators were so desperate to exclude it, di ba? So yun yung ano nila, yun yung indication. People then started to believe that the envelope was important. So nung hindi pinakita yan, Kenny, over here, nung hindi pinakita yung laman ng envelope, edi lalong nag-ano yung mga tao. Kenny, that's my other cat. I have, no, yeah, he's hungry. Go to Ate. So again, you know, Maharlika says that there is one. For us, she's the only one who knows with certainty, even if she has not actually seen it, that the video exists. And she says that ang basis niya for believing this is because it's being sold. Well, there are attempts to sell it. I don't know if anybody actually bought it. Sabi ni JC, ERAP was in office less than 2 years. So, but the GMA, so January 20, 2001, 2 years, less than 2 years. Ayan. Ang galing nga ng GMA formula kasi dapat yan, dapat yan, 3 years Dapat nasa 3 year level pero nakakuha siya ng ruling from the Supreme Court that allowed her to run again. So if that is the precedent, then she can, whoever is the successor here, whoever takes over, assuming that all of these things happen, could do so only after the 2 year period has expired. Okay, other questions? Sabi ni Ray, the Hello Garci controversy was at its peak, correct? The AFP and the PNP were about to take action, but the question was, who will succeed? Noli was seen to be very weak, so that's how GMA survived. I knew it because I was deeply embedded then in the war room during that time. Congratulations. I'm glad there's somebody here with personal knowledge. Sabi nga ni Turquoise Blue, aba, ngayong hapon po sa vlog ni Maharlika, hinamon na niya ang house, natawagin na siya sa Kongreso para mapatunayan kung meron nga ba talaga o wala. So, ilang ano na lang ba? It's January, so July pala dapat. Please. Alright. Sabi ni Abu Orhel sa Luminous Group, assuming may video, pwedeng gamitin yung illegal wiretapping para hindi mapakita sa hukom yung video? Kailangan, well, yeah, of course, it will kikilatisin yan ng ano, hindi, pwedeng ang court yung mag-decide. Pwedeng ipakita siya sa court. Isasubmit siya pa rin sa court. Pero magmo-motion yung lawyers to exclude it from being considered as evidence. Regardless of whether the judge sees it or not. Pwede kasing makita or pwede rin, we are presenting as evidence ganito. Yo-oppose ng prosecution or ng defense, depending who's submitting it, yo-oppose ng defense saying that it is illegal wiretap and therefore fruit of the poison tree. So pagka ganon, hindi pwedeng isumite, hindi pwedeng i-consider yan as evidence. Absolutely barred siya if it is wiretapped evidence. Sino yung nagsusorry at bakit po kayo nagsusorry? CRTB asks, when did the COMELEC formulate the gender? That's not the COMELEC, it's the Supreme Court po. Sabi ni Bobby Rubio, so anong dapat namin gawin pag panoorin at ito-tolerate na lang ba namin ginagawa ni Smug at Kuting? Well, if you have issues with the administration, then you must speak up pa rin. Diba? Bakit? May mawawala ba if you stop talking? Nobody is saying that you should stop being critical. Nobody is saying that we cannot keep educating people on the mistakes, the incompetence, if any, ha, of this administration. Nobody is saying you have to stop. Yeah? Nobody is saying you have to continue either. The idea is, if there is something wrong going on, don't keep it to yourself. Sabi ni Kenneth, wala po bang sisilip sa PCSO? May nanalo na namang lone bettor. May nanalo na naman. Parang linggo-linggo nga may nananalo. The problem is, yung statistical improbability is not yet an acceptable allegation sa Supreme Court. Eh. So, pwede sigurong manawagan tayo ng investigasyon sa PCSO kasi but we need to support that with statistical evidence. Tanong natin kina Dr. Guido, di ba? Sabi ni Laong Laan, kung may video ba, automatic na tanggal siya o may trial pa mangyayari? It really depends. In the ERAP envelope, there was an impeachment trial ongoing, tapos sumabog na lang yung galit ng mga tao and then there was a takeover. Diba? The reason I put it in question marks is because challenge talaga yung legality ng pag-takeover at that time. So yun. So, kailangan may impeachment proceeding. Ako, para sa akin, ha, it would be better if there was an impeachment proceeding. And later on, baka magkaroon ng succession. Magkakaroon ng succession if mayroon ngang guilty verdict. Sabi ni Rose, tuloy po ba yung petition for withdrawal of support? Wala na kasi po. Di na ma-access. Yun lang naman kasi ang paraan para maka-voice out kaming mga citizens. No, ma'am, you can voice out just by posting online on your social media. Now, bakit po nawala? Kasi mayroon pong nag-file doon sa change.org to remove it. Saying, I think that it was illegal or immoral or something like that. Sabi ni Antonio, kahit pinatay nila yung FBA, na-expose na yung mga... At halatang, may kinatatakutan din sila and they don't want to keep these people talking. Okay. Hi kay Venom Snake. Bago daw siyang nag-subscribe dito sa YouTube. O yung mga hindi pa nagsusubscribe sa YouTube, hindi ko po nakikita pa yung mga sinasabi ninyo. Pwede po bang hahalili ang iba maliban kay VP Pansamantala hanggang umabot ng 3 years tapos ipasa na kayo? Mamadali kayo, ma'am. Para sa akin, I don't know if that's even possible. Diba? Sabi ni Alan, ako lang ba ang nasad after napanood CFPRD kagabi? Or kanina? Well, naiintindihan ko because what he keeps saying is that retired na siya and he's not in politics anymore. And remember, sinabi niya na posibleng tumakbo siya for Senate or later, or maybe for Congress later. If VP Inday is impeached. Pero kung wala namang issues with this government, then he is enjoying his retirement. Sabi ni Brisa, pag nagtagumpay yung Chacha People's Initiative and BBM steps down, can Sara become a successor? People's Initiative. Well, yung People's Initiative only gives Congress more powers, more, expands the powers of Congress para kaya nilang kontrolin ang charter change. And I think that's what President Duterte, former President Duterte was also talking about kanina sa ano, sa kanyang press conference. Doon sa yesterday, sorry. Sa press conference niya, remember that he mentions, ano na nga ba yan? Remember that he mentions na, ako nawala yung train of thought ko. Ulit ha. Nagtagumpay, ah. He mentions na hindi dapat ganun kadali ang pagbabago ng constitution kasi that is very unstable. So it's pahapyaw siya eh. Kasi yun nga eh, ang current proposal under People's Initiative is to expand the powers of Congress so that sila at any time pwede silang mag-propose ng pagbabago sa saligang batas, tapos sila din yung magbabago nun. Uupo sila as a constituent assembly. Tapos tayo, ang participation lang natin ay doon sa ano, sa referendum. Sabi ni Joseph De La Cruz, balik na tayo sa Demo Pera yan, hashtag. Pwede rin. Sabi ni Ma'am Mima Herrera, double speak FPRD, no one can read his mind and his next steps. Grandmaster strategist, I believe he will not just sit idly by as the country he so painstakingly saved from the dogs be thrown mercilessly back to the dogs by the powers that be. So, may nagsasabi, sabi ni Hong Bao, meron daw po bang live press si First Lady ngayong gabi? Wala po akong balita na ganon, but thank you for that. It certainly is very exciting. Ayun, walang sound kasi ayaw, maingay yung kawawa naman. I'm so sorry guys. Nakamute ako kanina because maingay si Yoshi. I had to turn it off. Hindi po sabotahe, hindi po. Okay? Sabi ni Joseph De La Cruz, kalma na tayo. At balik tayo sa hashtag, eh, hindi mo pera yan. Okay? So, okay na. Chill, chill, chill. What happened pala? Why nag-surgery siya? Na-curious to know kay Yoshi. Well, he had a fight with Cerberus. And si Cerberus is a Belgian Malinois, fully grown. And nag-hold back pa si Cerberus niyan, pero siya kasi yung ano eh, siya yung sutil eh. Bakit, why is this important in this discussion? Tinatanong ni kusina ni Uncle, sobrang out of topic kasi nakakaano yung ganyan, sir. Well, tama ba daw na ang JO employees pay for, this is the last out of topic question I'm going to deal with kasi pina-flood mo eh. But it doesn't mean that I'm happy just because I'm answering your question. Should pay for notarization fee of our contract with the government agency. It depends on what the policy of the government agency is. Pwedeng hati, I think that would be more equitable. But yes, there's nothing illegal with the agency asking you to pay for it. Ito, sabi ni Josefina Goso, inechipwera ng appeals, ng Court of Appeals, yung kanilang petition. I think meron silang bagong petition. To question yung bagong organ deciding body, yung NTC, pero sila din po ang complainant. So yun po ngayon yung kini-question ni na, let's see. Sabi ni Ganley, ang solid Duterte, tahimik lang, huwag tayong maniwala sa mga video. Pulmura na yan, dito tayo sa tunay na issue. Yung sikat ni SU. Open the book. Pwede ba medyo nakakairita na yung open the book? Open the books of accounts. Okay? Hindi open the book kasi baka kung anong libro lang ang bigay sa atin. Open the books of accounts. Hindi ko ba, wag na lang kasi books. Kasi ang layo dun sa topic. Hindi ba pwedeng show us your ano liquidation? Tungkol sa extraordinary fund, okay. Ito, sabi ni Hong Bao, drug test sa mga nasa gobyerno mula sa pinakataas hanggang pinakamaliit. This is a good point. Na empleyado ng gobyerno at ibalik ang death penalty. Bakit di magawa yun? Well, yung death penalty has to be by legislation. So, ididibatihin pa yan po sa Kongreso. Ngayon, yung drug test, tama kayo. Kasi meron tayong mandatory tapos random drug testing sa gobyerno. Talagang meron gano'n na yung mga ahensya. At tama ka na kung i-drug test natin ang mga empleyado, dapat all the way to the top. Ang labo nito, Kenneth, ha? Para madisiplina ang mga tao, pareho daw yung kilo ng bigas sa presyo ng alak. Mm-hmm. Okay, if you're going to, yan. Sabi ni Ram Dordator, pwede po nakasuhan ng economic sabotage ang mga naninira sa ating gobyerno at mga nagmamanipula. Hindi po sa mga naninira ng gobyerno. Kasi naninira is actually a conclusion. Kayo yung nagsasabing naninira. Pero dahil meron tayong freedom of speech, maaari tayong mag-criticize ng gobyerno. Pagka lumampas na dun sa fairness, kumbaga, may malicious imputation of a crime, vice, or defect, or paninira ng reputasyon na walang basihan, then maaaring mag-file din kasi ng reklamo ang mga kawani ng gobyerno na napapatamaan sa mga kritisismo na ito. Gayunpaman, sinasabi ng Korte Suprema na mataas ang standard, ang evidentiary requirement kapag ikaw ay public figure para mapatunayan yung malisya na ng pagsasalita ng libel sa inyo, kasi dapat hindi onion skin ang government officials and employees. So, hindi po yon. Sa paninira po, hindi. Walang economic sabotage dyan. Yung nagmamanipulate ng presyo ng bigas, I'm trying to see, agricultural importations po kasi ang economic sabotage. Hindi po yung price manipulation dito sa Pilipinas. Tama naman si Mount Camien. Sabi niya, criticism ba yung may video? Tapos in the end, wala naman pala. Totoo yan. Tama naman po kayo doon. Sabi ni Gio, kuting silence means he is guilty. Well, not necessarily, but it is evidence na he is not reacting in a regular way. Kasi kung ikaw ay, normally yan pag sinabi, ikaw, magnanakaw ka. Hoy, hindi ako magnanakaw. Yung reaction, yung spontaneous reactions are evidence of guilt or innocence.
No.
Okay. Yoshi. Okay. Sabi ni Adrian, inflation is down, shabu prices down. Good job sa government. Lokong to. Maling produkto ang nagmura. Taong bayan ang nagmumura din. Sabi ni Christine Ong, would you recommend people to sign the People's Initiative Chacha yan, ha? Being circulated along with Ayuda? No, of course not. Is it safe to sign knowing hindi naman yata yung ni-explain? Yun na nga po, ma'am naman. No-brainer naman po ito. Ilang beses naman po namin sinabi. Itong People's Initiative na ito expands the powers of Congress so that at any time and for any reason, they can actually propose the amendments to the Constitution. They can do it on simply on the call of the speaker. So, tapos sila lang yung boboto. Wala na, bali, wala na yung boto ng Kongreso kasi 24 lang naman sila. So, what does this mean? Kung anong maisipan ni speaker, o tara, mag-constituent assembly tayo, ito yung proposal, ganito. And of course, since they can load it up, di ba? They can phrase it in such a way as to make sure that the answer could be misleading, and so it could mislead people into answering yes or no or something like that. Ang laki ng powers nila. Hindi po ako nawawalan ng audio when I have to tell one of my kids to do something, I have to turn off the audio kasi maririnig mo kami, di ba? Sabi ni Neil Nomine, no to cha-char. In its current form, in people who are sitting too. Totoo yan, Ma'am Christine. Sabi niya, magandang malinaw kasi may iba na they don't understand basta may pera sa harap nila. O nga, para sa akin, how is this not a vote buying? Hindi ba vote buying ito? Hindi ba they're gaming the People's Initiative? Ito pa! Bakit hindi nilalabas hanggang ngayon kung sino yung organizers nitong People's Initiative? At saka napakalaking coincidence naman. Sinabi ni Speaker Romualdez, we should change the Constitution. And suddenly, weeks lang, two, three weeks later, meron ng People's Initiative. What an amazing coincidence, which we shouldn't believe. Sabi ni Jeff, pwede bang mag-demand ng hair follicle test sa president to know if he's negative sa mga illegal substances? Okay, this is my take on that. Take note that this is a take, ha? So it's my opinion. For me, yes. But we have to phrase it correctly. Now, addiction is a health issue. It's not just a crime, it is also a health issue, di ba? Now, if there is a strong indication that the president might be involved in this, then the health kasi of the president is national interest. At mayroong requirement of disclosure ito sa ating saligang batas. I have to do a separate live for this para makita natin yung mga requirements and exactly what should be disclosed to the people. But if we make it a health issue, then yes, it is possible to demand it. Now, what I'm saying here is, I'm not saying it is true or it is not true, but this is how we can ask for it. Sabi ni Dio, bakit sa admin ni FPRD ay grabe ang suporta ng magsuporta ng majority ng Pinoy samantalang si President Marcos, ang mainstream media, ang sobrang suporta while majority of Pinoys ay galit? Maybe it's because of what people see. Parang hindi nakikita yung kind of governance dati where we were satisfied that even if hindi perfect, di ba? Even nasasatisfy pa rin tayo na may nakikita tayong mga galawan na that was not evident in other administrations. Ito sabi ni BCPIN3TV. Huwag niyo na i-rehash ang mga binasag na narrative ni FPRD. Balikan nyo pa eh si Digong na nagsabi. So ano nga yung sinungaling si... Hindi! You didn't listen, ano? Ay, sorry. Okay. The president did not say with absolute certainty that a video exists or not. He also made a conjecture. Kasi ang sinasabi niya, wala yan. Kasi kung totoo yan, dapat nilabas na yan. So what he's saying is that one, he doesn't know, and two, he's guessing as to why it's not coming out. But because how can he say with absolute certainty, eh hindi naman niya alam if the video even exists or not. Diba? That's amorphous. Nobody knows yet. Or at least the general public. Only those who have copies or a copy of that video, if it exists. So, no, you cannot make that conclusion, binasag na narrative. Did you listen to his words? This guy is a lawyer, so he had to be very careful with what he was saying. So, no, he did not say that doesn't exist. Alam kong hindi walang ganyan. He said, kasi kung may ganyan, eh dapat nilabas na. Which is why nagla-live tayo ngayon. Nagpresenta tayo ng teorya kung bakit hindi yan dumalabas aside from the fact that it, aside from the theory that it does not exist. Okay, so ang theory ni PBB, PRRD, FPRD is it doesn't exist kasi kung sakali, dapat lumabas na yan. Ang theory natin is whether or not it exists, hindi yan pwedeng ilabas kasi wala sa timing. Wala sa timing because kung inihabol natin ang possible succession or we need to protect the successor, it has to be done at a time when that successor, if having proven that the current occupant of the position is incapable of continuing in office, then the GMA formula can kick in. Okay? So, what you have isn't one sure answer and one theory. What you have are simply two theories. So no, that would be an incorrect interpretation of what the president said. Sabi ni Reynaldo, daming nabud ni BBM dahil sa pangarap niya na hanggang ngayon walang natutupad. Marcos loyalists na lang ang naniniwala sa kanya. Uy, marami rin tumawid ng Marcos loyalists. Ito, tama sabi ni CEO Kyun Soo. Sabi pa nga ni Presidente, di na bago yung mga gumagamit na talaga sa gumagamit na taga-gobyerno. Okay? So itong si ano, si sino ba yung commenter kanina? Falsus in uno, falsus in todo. if you lie in one statement, then the rest of your statements are not credible. So you cannot pick and choose. So sinabi rin ni President, ni former President Duterte, na may mga officials who use. Ngayon, are you saying that you believe one statement but you don't believe the other? So, at sinabi din po yan ni Maharlika. Naniniwala kayo dun sa ibang sinasabi ni Presidente Duterte, pero dun sa hindi kayo naniniwala sa dating mga yung sinasabi, pero ngayon naniniwala na kayo. Okay? So, don't mistake yung gigil ninyong makita yung video with there is no video. Diba? Kayo yung nanggigigil eh. Meron dito inip na na makita. Yung iba, ayaw talaga nilang maniwala na may video, so they're saying na wala yung video kasi hindi nilalabas. But there is a plausible explanation for that. What I'm saying is that it is a possible explanation because again, none of us know if that video exists. Sabi ni Jeff, what if hindi niya sasagutin yung COCA issue? Still considered po ba na betrayal of public trust? Ano ba? High crimes na yan. Diba? Why would you not participate in an exercise that can exonerate you? So, isa pa. Alam ko na may theory na umiikot dun sa kabila that the former president actually has a copy of the video. So his statement today negates that theory. Kumbaga, negates that suspicion. Kumbaga, dinideny niya. Oh, may mga nagsasalitang ganun. O, di sige, sagutin ko ganito. Wala yan. Doesn't exist. Hanin says, the reason this admin cannot address the issue is because they know it exists. And once it is proven over time, the people will lose 100% of their trust in the admin, hence the latter will have no chance of appealing itself to the people for consideration whatsoever. After all, who among sane Filipino citizens will renew their trust in an admin that blatantly lied? Bitin po, hindi po makita yung buo. Sabi ni Tej, kumbaga, PRD is laying the premise na wala siyang kaugnayan kung meron o wala. Sabi ni Freddy Orendina, Jason sa saw the 15-minute video. Nagparinig kasi si Sir Jay. And if you interpret it a certain way, then it indicates that he had seen a video. By the way, guys, nobody says, Maharlika makes reference to a video. I understand, but there might not be just one. Okay? Daming nanonood. Sabi ni user, ako naniniwala kay Maharlika at SAS. User, hindi ko nakuta. Sabi ni Jack, alam nyo, PRD is a game master. I agree also. Sandali, ayusin ko lang to. Ayan, para mas madali makita yung ano. Sabi ni Dot, sabi ni PRD, mahina na siya, hindi na niya kaya sa 2025. Ano to, drama lang? Kunyari, ayaw? Kayo naman? Kailan ba siya nagkaroon ng ano? Di ba? We all deserve the right to change our minds. Yun yung unang tanong sa akin nung appointed. Dati, bakit ka mag-stay? Sabi ni Gear, yung mga pula na affected sa existence ng video, edi huwag kayong manood ng vlog nila. Ang dami yan. Kaya lang, I expected this. Kaya natatawa na lang ako. Because of course, they have no ready answer. So, for those who are against the idea of a video, I'm very worried. They have no answer. I bet you didn't see this coming. Sabi ni Stormy, ako naniniwala na series ang bulbulong video. Okay, sabi ni Pochi, do you think PRD is still in his right mind or signs of aging na? I talked to him personally and no signs of aging. Ano nga lang, hindi lang siya makasyadong makapagmotor. But very, very sharp and grabe yung memory. Sabi ni si Haya, if the video exists, is it enough reason for impeachment? Yes. But if Congress resists it and people are angry, then what you will have next is something like ERA. Sabi ni Seok Yun Su, kasalanan na naman ni PRD yan, ginulong lahat. Thank you kay Rolando Plaza, oops, for your super sticker. Alam nyo, para dun sa mga nasa TikTok, ay, well, sa lahat actually, dito sa mga live ko, hindi po, yung mga obvious flaws, oh, hindi namin pinapansin yan. But even if you don't agree with us, pero polite kayong magtatanong, sinasagot po namin. Para dun sa sanay sa akin, lalo na dun sa mga live ko, pag TikTok lang ang audience, you know, they can, basta maayos yung pagtatanong, masasagot ko kayo. Pero kung nandito kayo just to hate, tandaan po ninyo, maaari naman po kayong mablock. Eto, si Ma'am Christine has a good take. Sabi niya, hindi uubrang, he who accuses must prove we are not in court. And this speculation puts BBM's capacity to lead in question. Tumugot dapat agad na hindi ito totoo. Yep. Lalo-lalo na because it is destabilizing. Diba? Oo, tama kayo, Miss Christine. Kasi, kung wala naman din kasing evidence, this is simply talk. People believe that there are things going on that the admin might need to explain. Eh, instead of addressing the issue, nagkakaroon ng takedowns. Merong mga trolls na nag-a-attack ng personalan and so on. And these trolls are very, very clearly in the payroll because they don't make a secret of it anymore. Di ba? Di nga nila dinideny na bayaran sila eh. So, ang punto dito is that the deadma, which is interpretable as fear or reluctance, the trolls that are on overdrive without very much logic, the actions that tend to make people, that tend to suppress free speech, they're indicative that something is wrong. A normal reaction would be, what? No, that's not true. Diba? Because if it really isn't so, then nobody will ever be able to come up with evidence for that. Video or no video. Diba? Pag sina, and if somebody says, ay, eh, paano kung doktor, na doctor din yung video? Dude, nadidetect na po yung mga yan. Sabi ni Xerxes, BBM should just heed Locke's advice. Just do the drug test, submit urine and hair strand specimen and publicize the results. It would certainly go a long way. Sabi ni Eduardo, deny for the meantime, then heighten the surprise later on at the proper time. It's like saying, hindi ako tatakbo, and then surprise, tumakbo. Okay. Okay. Yeah, sure. You can keep telling yourself that. Did you listen to the video? Did you listen carefully? It was speculation. And what you're saying is that FPRD said to the effect that there is no video. To the effect, really? He was saying, he was speculating. He was basing it on the fact that it had not come out. Now, we provided a plausible explanation as to why it isn't coming out, which negates now, or possibly negates, or increases the number of theories that are out there, indicating that this is just another one of those speculations. Okay? He said he's also satisfied with the government and corruption, etc. Did you see it? Yes, of course. But this guy, I wouldn't trust him not to change his mind either. Or there's also another reason. Para sa akin, sure. For me, this is indicative that you're giving a lot of weight to what President Duterte is saying, ha? Huh? And sure, ako, I give it a lot of weight. But I have my own opinion on that. Kasi ako, we report all of we report this, and every day there's something new. Ba? What the promise, what about sa agri? Well, the president was talking about corruption. But me, what about incompetence? Because you can impeach for incompetence as well. Because you know what incompetence is? If your government officials are failures, that's still corruption. Because the people are not getting their value for money. In your personal view, would you like the video to show now? No. Even if there's no gulo, no? Even if there's no speculative succession happening, I don't want it to come out now because I like seeing people running scared. Okay. Yeah, that's interesting. Sana, attorney, sabi ni Jay, pag public official at may controversial na ganyan na issue, regardless, videos man yan, wiretap, matik, sana na walang immunity with the guard coming from foot of a poisonous street. Hindi po kasi immunity yan eh. It's a rule of evidence. Kasi if we allow evidence that's illegally obtained, then we are, you know, we're tolerating crimes. Lalo-lalo na yung mga violation of privacy. Sabi ni Ma'am Susan Marcelo, nakakabingi kasi ang katahimikan ng palasyo. Dapat kung may mga malicious na comments about government or the president for that matter, dapat maagap sila na sagutin para wala nang duda ang mga tao. Akala ko ba magagaling ang mga tao na iuupo nila sa communications team niya, pero parang mahina o walang experience ang mga nakapalibot sa kanya. Ang ano ko nga, Ma'am Susan, is wala dapat maagap sila sagutin. Walang, it doesn't even have to be malicious. But here's my experience. Normally, pagka may ganitong mga issues na lumalabas, something controversial, ang nangyayari is the media will ask. Kasi sa press briefing, magtatanong talaga ang media. So, in this case, walang briefing man lang. So, there is very little information coming out. Ang masakit niyan is, nagre-rely yata sila dun sa kanilang mga trolls who don't disseminate information, but instead, just try to take down or ruin the reputations and credibility of those who speak the truth or facts or whatever, or alternatives to their narrative. May magagawa pa ba daw para dun sa pagpipirma? Yes, we have to constantly and continuously report it. And let's see kung merong ano, merong mag-file ng kaso sa Supreme Court. Okay? Pwede po kasing if ano eh, kasuhan 'yan eh. Kasi dapat people's initiative 'yan. Pero kung government sponsored, kung may pera nang galing dun sa, let's say, some government official, hindi na po yan people's initiative. What if the video ay ilalabas from China or Russia? May magagawa ba ang gobyerno para mahabol ang pagpapalabas? Wala ngang territoriality, ano? Pero ang tingin ko dyan is, what is the value? Kasi may video pero wala naman, if it goes to court or if it goes to an impeachment trial, sinong magte-testify to that? Natatawa ako. Dun sa mga tao na galit kay Duterte, pinipilit nila na tama si Duterte dun sa sinasabi niya, guys, make up your mind. Huwag niyo akong sigawan, Henry, ha? Ano masasabi mo? Sabi niya ganun. Tigil-tigilan niyo nga ako sa mga, napanood niyo ba ito? Ano masasabi mo? Galit na galit? Angry? Bakit? Why? And why are you compelling me to answer? Diyos kong mahabagin. Paano kung sabihin ko sa'yo, hindi ko napanood yung video, o di tablado na? Ay nako, guys. Seriously. Wala lang kayong masagot dito, ililihis ninyo. Ang issue is whether or not, well, not really an issue. We're just discussing about this alleged video, di ba? Cherry, ayan, sabi ni Christine, ay, nako. Yun. Cherry picking to the max yung ginagamit si PRD. Binabastos siya most of the time. Tapos if he says something they agree with, push us to believe it. Kaloka kayo. At least kami, hindi kami yung super duper na nga idol ng kung sino-sino. Kasi kahit si Pangulong Duterte, kino-call out namin nung presidente siya. At kahit si Pangulong Duterte, pag may sinabi siya na ayaw namin, ay nakakaano rin siya. Kahit kami, sasabihin namin, no. Sabi ni Ian, kamusta ang katahimikan at mga huliglig ng PCO. Grabe, ang harsh. Anong sinabi? The United States of America pays for your police forces, pays for your army and navy. Does it? Of course not. Oh my goodness, Daniel Luke. What did the US pay? They're not paying for any police forces. They're not paying us for anything. Your military has access to our bases. They get to build their own structures, and those structures, they pretend that it's going to go to us. But like what happened with Clark and Subic, some of the stuff that you left, aside from nuclear waste, were buildings that were in disrepair. Tigilan ako. And you know what? They didn't even give us favored nation status in our export. He told us when we were negotiating for the access to military bases that that's off the table. And that came right out of the mouth of your secretary. Sabi ni Roland, paano makasign ng manifesto? I think it has gotten off. Natanggal na po siya sa change.org. So if ever we're going to have to, ano, we're going to have to circulate a hard copy. Sabi ni Ma'am Susan, malaking kawalan ka po sa team ni BBM, di man lang sila nag-isip nung inalis ka. Well, umalis ako. Very professional ka po when you tackle issues. Parang ayaw ng palasyong ganyang Uy, grabe kayo. I don't think so naman. It's just that they have, how do you call this? Organizational problems. Sabi ni Lindy, di po kaya tahimik ang palasyo kapag may controversies para wag nang madagdagan pa, para they might do their things or responses in other democratic ways. Mama, I don't think it's working, whatever it is they're doing right now. Kasi if they did something right, then tapos na yung issue ng video. Noong umpisa nga eh, without this current theory, noong umpisa, they could very well have said, ebidensya nyo, wala, di ba? Walang video. Ang ebidensya. And now, but if you consider other circumstances, tapos you take into consideration the fact na nagtitigil sila or nagtatanggal sila ng mga, ano, ng mga accounts, then, we really question na, di ba? Teka, pasalamat muna ako kay Rolando Plaza, Dolce Vita, FMR Reyes, Ramona Villasis and Angel for your super chats and super stickers sa YouTube. Sa Facebook din, hindi ko po nakikita yung mga stars kasi dito sa StreamYard hindi po nakikita eh. Sabi ni Judith, ayaw kasi ng admin na matitinong secretary. Grabe! Bakit naka-deactivate yung FB ni Motherland ngayon? Hindi ko po alam. I have to ask her if contactable siya. So, natawa naman ako. Sabi ni Naignis, ah, kaya pala, ginagamit yung term na binasag. May script. Binanatan ni Coach Garrett, si Attorney Harry Roque, kasi binasag daw niya siya ni FPRD kahapon sa press con nila, kaya pinagtawanan ni Garrett si Attorney Harry. Hashtag Duterte pa rin, hashtag hindi mo o ipera yan. Well, thank you very much for that information. But I think he is mistaken kasi the presumption nga is that this conjecture of President Duterte, since there are no other plausible explanations, can be taken at face value. But again, it is a conjecture. Is he saying that that President Duterte has personal knowledge of this some way, somehow? And, you know, after bashing him for so many times, now you're suddenly claiming credibility on his part? Sabi ni Just Marvel, I'm disappointed, pero nagiging kalmado kasi nandiyan ka to explain. Well, you know, some people don't really want us to be calm, okay? They want agitation. They want people to be angry so that we cannot think straight, okay? But we can be angry and still thinking as long as we keep to the logic of things, diba? Okay. Sabi ni Arlan, hindi ma-challenge ng government or admin na ilabas ang evidence because they know baka makuryente sila. Because kung hindi totoo, nakapag-release na sila ng statement. Also, another good one, di ba? It's another guess. It's another conjecture also. All of this is in the realm of conjecture. But what we're saying is that in addition, okay, ang sinasabi kasi ng iba, kung nag-i-exist yan, dapat nilabas na yan. Tapos it ends there. Yung evidence nila is hindi nila labas. Now tayo, ang sinasabi natin, there is a GMA formula and you have to factor that in the timing of the release of the video, if it exists. And third, di ba, the opposite can also be said, that the video exists because hindi kumikibo ang Malacanang at a time na their kibo is very much needed kasi nagsusnowball po yung issue. People are believing it because there is no ano, there is no other indication. Lalong-lalo na parang nagre-react with suspicion yung mga ano, and the trolls are super active. Accounts are getting taken down. There seem to be moves to suppress the freedom of speech. Kahit mismo yung Kongreso, they're trying to come up with more, ano, with more, ano bang mga to, with more reasons to, ano, more reasons to curtail more freedoms. Yeah. Sabi ni Gear, hahaha, magbibigay sila ng statement after 3 months pag negative na sa hair follicle test.
Joke.
It's a good joke. Sabi ni Alvin, BBM shouldn't have to defend himself from those accusations kung wala naman video na nilalabas, no need. Ah, okay, then let's talk about need. Okay? The need is destabilization. The need is the uncertainty with government. The need is that people are restless. And if you care about the people, if you are a true leader, then you would care about what your constituents think. It is in the nature of a leader to address the issues of his people. So you can't hide behind the wala kayong proof. Nagkakagulo or posible magkagulo or people demand an explanation. And if you ignore that explanation, if you ignore addressing the worries of your people, you're no leader. You're just somebody who occupies that office. Uy, sinasabi ni Mike, nilaglag daw tayo. Sabi ni Mike Puentes, wala na siyang credibility kasi siya pa si Muno ng drug issue na yan noong 2021, tapos nilaglag niya kayo kagabi. Sinong nilaglag? Did the president even acknowledge na kami yung kami or tayo or DDS or people related to him are talking about this? Eh kahit dito sa namin sa vlog namin, we always say if the video exists. Now, what's he saying? He disagrees with us? So what? Unlike you na jokes box. Okay? Kayo kailangan husana agree ng agree. Pero kami, panahon pa lang ni Duterte as president, we would disagree with him also. So, I'm sorry, but that doesn't fly. Alright, so, last 3 questions. Sabi ni Ma'am Unique, naging topic niyo minsan, attorney, itong tungkol sa People's Initiative at sa tingin ko nagkaroon sila ng idea. Pero mas angkop ang Tambaloslos Initiative. So I think it's time for us also to remind people of the constitutional of how to conduct amendments, how to amend the Constitution. Diba? Ito sabi ni user 1174655094983. I-deny lang din ni BBM yan kung sasagutin niya talaga. Yes, but why doesn't he do it? It's the easiest thing in the world to deny. Diba? So, that's ridiculous. He can even say, it's so ridiculous, it does not merit an answer. Why doesn't he do it? Okay, so ang nangyayari, ang nakikita natin, yung kanilang pushback is simply this. Walang video. Hindi talaga, I insist, walang video. Sure, believe whatever you want. Di naman kami nagko-complain. Kahit naman kami sinasabi namin, we don't know if it exists. We don't know if it doesn't exist either. Diba? So parang Schrodinger's cat. At the moment, it both exists and does not exist. Until it shows up. On that note, maraming salamat to everybody who participated here. Yes, especially the trolls, because you have pushed our live video, viewers to 5,000, which is one of the biggest so far lately. Ah, lately 5,000 Facebook and YouTube combined, and ilan dito sa 22,000 sa TikTok. So thank you very, very much. I like the fact that you're here because you push up engagement and you kick the algorithm and you make it better, diba? You increase our reach. So I really have to thank everybody who's here. Yes, even those people who don't like me and yet keep watching because guys, secretly you're fans. And thank you very, very much also because it's been such a fruitful discussion. we can continue talking about this because it is a matter of public interest. Thank you for those who sent, you know, things like power hugs, diamonds, roses, and so on. So guys, everybody, please do take care. Take care of your health because the country needs you and they need you in good health. Sabi ni June, sana parati kang mag-vlog ng live. Araw-araw po kami nag-vlog. And yesterday, I was here. Kaya lang ito. Ah, hindi. Madaling araw. I was late kasi nagtatahi ako kagabi. So, mga 2 a.m. Ay, 1 o'clock na po ako nag-live sa, ano, dito sa TikTok last night. But, I missed 2 days here on Facebook and YouTube. Kasi, you know, I was upset over something. So, thank you very much, everybody. And thank you. Alam ko din yung iba ng mga bayaran dyan, naghahanap buhay lang po kayo. So, yung iba sa inyo, hindi ko na kayo dinilit because right now, I just need more comments so that you can push up our, ano, our visibility. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you very much, especially yung mga TikTokers dyan. Uy, na-miss ko yung mga college students. Are they busy? So, thank you very much, guys. Thank you, and have a good evening, everybody.